Another important maintenance job is to be sure that the brakes of your trailer are properly adjusted. Your trailer brakes have been especially designed in order to bring the vehicle to a safe stop and to assist your braking vehicle in doing the braking maneuver. In order to be sure that the brakes are operating at the best possible efficiency at all times, follow the following adjustments. Be sure that all the trailer wheels are in the air. It is important to do the brake adjustment on all the brakes at the same time. You will notice in this case that there is a lot of movement at the coupler, and if you look behind, you will notice that there's a lot of movement in the rod. The aim of this adjustment is to remove all of this free play and to be sure that the brakes are correctly set to make maximum use of the movement in the coupler of the trailer. Be sure that the brake cables are removed from the rod and be sure that the cables are free to slide in their housings. Remove the brake compensator to ensure that the cables are free to slide in their outer casings. This will ensure that the brake adjustment is smooth and proper. Once you have ensured that everything is loose, it is time to adjust the brake. The brake is adjusted using a suitable socket. You will see on the back plate, opposite the cable entry point, will be a hexagon nut. This is the brake adjuster, and it is usually a 19mm socket spanner required. Rotate the wheel in the forward direction only during the brake adjustment. Do not rotate the wheel in reverse. If you do, you will have to restart the adjustment procedure because the automatic reverse feature of the brake will be engaged. While rotating the wheel, turn up the adjustment nut until the wheel becomes impossible to rotate forward by hand. Once this has been achieved, release the nut one turn and then spin the wheel forward. Keep releasing the nut until the brake is no longer touching the drum. You will hear it. When the brake shoes no longer touch the drum, the wheel brake is properly adjusted. Push the rod toward the rear of the trailer until it can't be moved any further. Tighten the nut at the back of the compensator until it is just touching the compensator. Fit the cable nuts. You will notice there are two nuts. The big nut goes against the compensator, and it's normally a 17mm spanner. The small nut is used to lock the big nut, and that is a 13mm spanner. Once the nuts have been replaced, pull up the handbrake. It should stop and make an angle of 90 degrees with the coupler body. Once the handbrake makes an angle of 90 degrees with the coupler body, the adjustment process is complete. Then it is important to get back under the trailer, tighten up all of the nuts, be sure that there are no loose nuts in the system. Once the nuts have been locked into their correct position, the trailer can be lowered back onto the ground. If the wheels have been removed, it is important to refit the wheel nuts correctly. Ensure while the wheel is in the air, there is no play in the nuts and they are properly seated on the wheels. When the trailer has been lowered onto the ground, re-torque the nuts to the correct torque specification. In this case, the torque is 18 Newton meters. The last step of the adjustment is to take the trailer for a test drive. Do this in a suitable safe location where you can reach a speed of at least 40 kilometers per hour. Drive forwards up to 40 kilometers per hour, apply the brake slowly. Be sure that the trailer does not knock behind you. Drive forwards again, up to 40 kilometers an hour, and do an emergency stop. Once you've done an emergency stop, immediately reverse the vehicle. If the wheels bind when you're reversing, the brakes must be readjusted. If the wheels do not bind when you're reversing, the brakes have been correctly adjusted and you can carry on your way.